so I'm going to start out. How has your blogging experience gone?
Well, you're right. I mean, I started blogging really for two reasons. I mean, the first was that I was shamed into it by one of your blogs, because there was a conspiracy between Steve and the people in the embassy who do this, present here today. And so I was outed as someone who was pausing over his first blog, and so there was public pressure. I don't know if it was gentle pressure or not. And the second reason was that our then Foreign Secretary, our then Secretary of State, was an avid blogger himself, so I thought with my personal diplomatic skills I'd better get along with the project and do the same as my boss. So I got onto it. But I also realised that we had to do this, and that ambassadors need to do it just as much as the members of their teams. They haven't allowed me to tweet. I think that that's something that the next ambassador will have to do. But
tweeting's a really cool thing to do in retirement.
I don't know how many people follow me there, but I think it's been very useful, and we've covered a huge range of subjects, from the very serious to the less serious. What it's told me is that that you can certainly get your points across in Afghanistan and Iraq and Iran and everything else, but the blogs of ours which have done best have actually been on more cultural themes. I mean, we did a blog a couple of years ago on why British actors seem to get all the roles in vampire movies.
Let's get into some serious terrain. What were some of the toughest calls you had to make while you were here? I mean,
it's actually been the handling of BP and the oil spill last year. Which raises a number of issues. When something like that happens, it's a British-owned company, but it's also a huge international company, and we get, as I think everyone else got, conflicting feelings about this. On the one hand, the leading edge of our initial commentary had to be empathy with the people who were affected, obviously the people, founders, the people who were killed, but also the huge numbers of people in the region by the environmental and social aspects of the spill. But then watching some of the commentary here, watching some of the comments that were made here and the political pressure here, we also had to say something else, which is BP is not just a British company, it's an international company. Let this not become something which is about foreign companies or British companies. There's something that matters to Americans. There are as many American shareholders as British shareholders in BP. And we need to avoid language which drives down something which is an international and certainly UK-US asset. So we wanted to get across a complicated measure. We did that correctly and well in the end. But there were a few very difficult weeks where I felt the rhetoric was somehow at different stages, getting a bit ahead of itself.
And you were in an awkward position, sort of.
I didn't find it awkward. I think it was a challenge to us to get it right, and then to set down some lines in the sand.